And then let's say that you love that book, but you want some more examples. Then you might want to go to this yellow book, which is called An Introduction to Braille Mathematics. Now, I'm going to tell you that this particular book is actually for transcribers who are planning to be certified in transcribing in the NEMATH code. So this is the particular book that they would need to use. And this one just doesn't happen to be in a three-ring binder. It happens to be yellow, but I've had copies in beige and gray. So unfortunately, I can't say this is always the yellow book. But if you look inside, right. So if we look inside, we see that the official title is An Introduction to Braille Mathematics, but it's by Helen Roberts, Bernard Krebs, and Barbara Taffet. And again, it says right here that it's based on the NEMATH Braille Code for Mathematics and Science Notation 1972. In other words, it's based on the Green Book, and it also is available from the American Printing House for the Blind in both print and Braille on federal quota money. And I'm thinking the last time I saw this in Braille that it was only four volumes, but they were a lot thicker than the five volumes of the Green Book. Okay, now what I want to just show you again real quickly is, if you're looking at it, you're probably thinking, well, that looks exactly like the Green Book. And it does. It corresponds very much with that. So if references something in the Green Book, you'll be able to find it. However, what's different in this particular book are pages like this that say, for instance, homework, exercise 2. And it says, prepare the following homework for submission to your teacher. Proofread carefully. This means teacher, not your classroom teacher. This means the teacher who is checking your work and is going to eventually prepare you for certification to be a transcriber of the NEMATH code. But what you're going to notice is that there are just homework problems, exercises. There are no answers either here or in the back of the book. In fact, all you're going to get in the back of the book is that strange looking index again. And I won't cut in close and personal again, but just to let you know, if you look up exponents, won't be there. You've got to look under superscripts or subscripts for that part. Okay, now I do want to point out though what's kind of different about this book. It does show you some tables, but it also shows you some tactile graphics that might be interesting for you to be able to have that to look at. So gives you some charts, and again it gives you some figures and so forth. So again, a very valuable book in my opinion, mostly for more examples. And I get frustrated every now and then because the exercises actually don't have the answers. But that's because this is supposed to be for these transcribers that are studying, and they're not supposed to have the answers. They're supposed to be graded, and then they can go on and become a certified transcriber.